Hello students, hope you all are healthy and this is our first class after summer vacation. Now your summer vacations are over, so we'll start our classes from today. So students, in today's class we'll discuss the revision of chapter 1 and 2 of history. So we'll start the class with revision so that you can remember the points which we have discussed earlier. So let's continue with the chapter 1 of history, that is the medieval period. So students, the study of past is divided into three parts. इतिहास को पढ़ने के लिए हमने उसको तीन पार्ट्स में डिवाइड कर रखा है, एंड दैट इज द एंशिएंट पीरियड, द मेडिवल पीरियड एंड द मॉडर्न पीरियड. सो मेडिवल पीरियड लाइज बिटवीन एंशिएंट पीरियड एंड मॉडर्न पीरियड, एंड इन दिस चैप्टर विल रीड अबाउट द मेडिवल पीरियड. एंड मेडिवल पीरियड स्टूडेंट्स लास्टेड फॉर 1100 ईयर्स from early 8th to late 18th century. तो medieval period का total जो time था वो कितना था, around 1100 years. And it started from early 8th to late 18th century. And during this medieval period, lot of changes came in society, polity, economy. Means there was lot of changes made in our country during medieval period, which we'll read in this chapter. Students, the medieval period is divided into two parts, the early medieval period and the late medieval period. The time period of early medieval period is from 8th to 13th century, and the time period of late medieval period is from 13th to 18th century. Now student, the rulers who ruled over early medieval period was Rajputs, Rashtraputas, Palas, Gurjar Pratihars, Cholas and so on. And the rulers who ruled during late medieval period was Afghans, Turks, Mughals. By the end of 15th century, European traders started trade with India. Now our next one topic, that was changing terminology. In this topic, if you remember, we learned about different names of India, which means the name of our country changed from time to time at different phases. So India was known by different names during different periods of history. The earliest names of India was Jambudvip, Aryavart and Bharatvarsh. So Jambudvip, Aryavart and Bharatvarsh, ye Bharat ke sabse purane naam the. And after that, Hindustan, India and Bharat वर द नेम्स ऑफ आर कंट्री. तो समय के साथ हमारे देश का नाम भी बदलता रहा है. जैसे कि सबसे पहले जम्बूद्वीप आर्यवर्त एंड भारत था, लेकिन उसके बाद चेंज होके हिंद नेम केम विद द इन्वेडर्स. व्हेन द इन्वेडर्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट कॉन्टिनेंट्स केम टू इंडिया, द नेम ऑफ आर कंट्री ऑल्सो चेंज विद देम. द नेम चेंज फ्रॉम भारतवर्ष टू हिंद एंड हिंदुस्तान. सो बाबर द मुगल रूलर यूज दिस टर्म फर्स्ट. बाबर जो मुगलिया शासक था, उसने सबसे पहली बार ये टर्म यूज किया था हमारे कंट्री के लिए, हिंदुस्तान. सो फ्रॉम हिंद द नेम ऑफ कंट्री चेंज टू हिंदुस्तान. एंड आफ्टर दैट इंडिया. इंडिया केम द नेम केम विथ Britishers. When British Raj was there in our country, the word Indi was used in English language as India and Bharat. Whereas in our Indian constitution, जबकि हमारे भारतीय संविधान में वी यूज बोथ द टर्म्स, हम दोनों टर्म्स यूज करते हैं, इंडिया एंड भारत. नाउ मैनी चेंजेस वर सीन ड्यूरिंग मेडिवल पीरियड. सो स्टूडेंट्स, चेंजेस वर सीन ड्यूरिंग मेडिवल पीरियड लाइक new technologies came in India with medieval period, and the technologies like spinning wheel and potter's wheel were came in use, and new food and beverages, new foods and drinks came from different invaders and different people who came from different continents. लोग दूसरे कॉन्टिनेंट से, द्वीपों से हमारे देश में आए और वो अपने साथ अपना फूड और अपना ड्रिंक भी लाए. एंड न्यू लैंग्वेजेस विथ न्यू इन्वेडर्स एंड न्यू पीपल, मैनी न्यू लैंग्वेजेस ऑल्सो केम टू आर कंट्री. एंड न्यू रिलीजन्स ऑल्सो केम विथ पीपल फ्रॉम डिफरेंट कॉन्टिनेंट्स. Like Islam and Christianity came to India during medieval period. So मध्यकाल के दौरान जो दो नए धर्म आए वो थे Islam and Christianity. So students, that time caste system was also very rigid in our country. उस समय में जातिवाद भी हमारे देश में बहुत ज़्यादा कठोर था. लोग caste में, सब caste में divide थे, and they were very rigidly following this castes and subcastes. Now the next topic was sources of history. Now what are the sources which give us information about the history? इतिहास के बारे में वो क्या तथ्य हैं जिनसे हमें जानकारी मिलती है? So basically there are two main sources of history that we have discussed. Archaeological sources and literary sources. Archaeological sources, पुरातात्विक literary source which are available in written form. So archaeological examples of archaeological sources are inscriptions. So students, archaeological sources are the direct sources of history which are available with us in material remnants. मतलब जो हमारे पास मटेरियल फॉर्म में अवेलेबल है वो पुरातात्विक सोर्स जो हमारे पास मटेरियल फॉर्म में अवेलेबल है. जस्ट लाइक इंस्क्रिप्शंस, मॉन्यूमेंट्स, कॉइन्स, पेंटिंग एंड स्कल्पचर्स. सो द फर्स्ट वन इज इंस्क्रिप्शंस. इंस्क्रिप्शंस शिलालेख, अ पीस ऑफ राइटिंग कार्व्ड ऑन अ रॉक और पिलर. कोई भी एक लेख जो कि किसी रॉक पे या पिलर पे इंग्रेव किया गया हो, दैट इज इंस्क्रिप्शंस. मॉन्यूमेंट्स स्मारक, द बिल्डिंग्स दैट हैव एनी हिस्टोरिकल इम्पोर्टेंस आर मॉन्यूमेंट्स. दैट टाइम मैनी ऑफ द किंग्स एंड रूलर्स मेड डिफरेंट monuments to show their power and so on, which are helpful and very important sources of history which give us various informations. And coins, we all are aware about coins. Coins are a part of our currency today also. Aaj bhi sikke hamari currency ka hissa hain. That time also coins were regulated by the kings. That is a part of archaeological sources and a very useful information sources which give us very important information about that period. Paintings available of that time, medieval period, are very important sources of archaeological sources. And sculptures, murtiyan. That time the sculptures made by the people are also an important archaeological sources. Now the next one source of history is literary sources. Literary sources are also the indirect sources of history. During medieval period, or we can say till medieval period, the use of paper was very common. पेपर का यूज़ बहुत कॉमन था. दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव प्लेंटी ऑफ मींस हमारे पास पर्याप्त मात्रा में लिटरेरी सोर्सेज अवेलेबल हैं ऑफ मेडिवल पीरियड्स. एंड व्हाट वर द लिटरेरी सोर्सेज लाइक कोर्ट क्रॉनिकल्स, बायोग्राफीज एंड ऑटोबायोग्राफीज, ट्रेवलॉग्स एंड रिलीजियस लिटरेचर. नाउ व्हाट आर कोर्ट क्रॉनिकल्स? For the writings written by historians and poets about the victory of the kings and about the life of the kings. Many of the court chronicles were written like Rajat Rangini by Kalhan, Tariq-e-Firozshahi by Ziauddin Barni, Khazain-ul-Futuh and Tughlaq-nama written by Amir Khusro and so on. Next one is biographies and autobiographies. What is the difference between biographies and autobiographies? Because in both we'll discuss the life of any of the king or ruler. So the difference between biography and autobiography is biography is written by someone else. Like biography of any ruler is written by any poet or any of the writer is known as biography. Whereas autobiography is written by the pupil himself. Like Babur wrote his autobiography Babarnama himself. And travelogues, Yatra Vrittant. So travelogues were written by the persons who came to India from outside, and they write down the history of that time, what they have seen, what was the condition during that time. And religious literature. So that time many regional literature was also written and religious literatures. So the famous religious जो कि धार्मिक साहित्य जैसे कि हम जानते हैं रामायण महाभारत and so on. And calligraphy was also very important. Many of the handwritten manuscripts in the medieval period were written. Now we'll discuss the second chapter of history. So students, let's do a quick revision of second chapter of history, that is rise of kingdoms. So in our second chapter of history, rise of kingdoms, we read about dynasties which ruled during the medieval period in India. वो dynasties जिन्होंने medieval period में India में rule किया, उनके बारे में हमने इस chapter में पढ़ा. So if you remember, the dynasties which ruled during early medieval period in India was Rajputs, the Gajnavids, the Ghorids, the Palas and the Gurjar Pratihars, and these dynasties were the powerful ones in the northern part of India. So Rajputs, Gajnavids, Ghorids, Palas and Gurjar Pratihars were the powerful rulers of northern India. Now the dynasties which ruled over the south region during medieval period was the Palas, the Pandyas and the Cholas. And the dynasties which ruled in the Deccan region was the Rashtrakutas, and few small kingdoms was also ruled during medieval period in the Deccan region. And this small kingdoms was the Yadavas of Devagiri, the Chalukyas of Kalyani and the Kakatiyas of Varangal and the Hoysalas of Dwar Samud. We learn about sculptures, trade, temples and inscriptions about the Chola dynasty in this chapter. So read the chapter properly to get the brief information or revision of the rise of kingdoms. So students, here we finish our class today. Now one more thing which you have to do regularly is, now you all have to come in comment section whenever you complete your video. जब भी आप अपना वीडियो देख के कम्प्लीट करें, after that you have to come in comment section and write down your name with your class and section, your present class and section, to mention your attendance, and that is must. You have to mention your attendance because I have to complete your attendance register for school. That's why it is very compulsory to write down your name with your class and section. Thank you.